Hello guys, in this video we will talk about SDS PAGE, which stands for sodium dodosulfate polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. SDS PAGE is discontinuous electrophoric system, means as we talked about that in the previous video, it contains two phases of the gel for separation. And it's mainly used for separate based on molecular weight, and it's more to be effective in the masses or molecular weight between 5 to 250 kilodalton. The principle of SDS PAGE is to normalize or remove the effect of charge and mass. As we know that the proteins are affected by three factors during the gel electrophoresis, which are the mass, charge, and molecular weight. So SDS PAGE remove those two factors, and molecular weight is the only factor to be considered. So this is occurred by providing the proteins with the same charge to mass ratio and let them move through sieving gel. So let's see how it works. In the beginning, samples need to be prepared, and for that the proteins need to be extracted, purified, and also quantified before this step. After that, you have the extracted, purified, and quantified. Also, you know the concentration of those proteins. You may go for sample preparation. Sample preparation is a step aims to denature the proteins and provide them in the correct structure and correct status for electrophoresis. Also, it helps to adjust the concentration in the sample. So those are the materials or chemical materials that are used in combination to prepare these samples. First of all, we have the trace. Trace is zwitterion, which is buffer. It's a little bit acidic. It's 6.8. So just remember that we will come back to this point later. The main issue of this buffer is to adjust pH that enable us to denature the proteins. Glycerol is used to give more density to the sample. So when during the loading process, the sample might float out of the gel. To deal with that, we provide some density by adding a glycerol. Also, we have SDS, which is the main chemical in this step. As you notice, it's amebathic surfactant, which means it has two portions, one polar and the another one is non-polar. So it can bind to the positively charged residues. And also it deals with the hydrophobic portions in the protein and stratify the whole protein, make it straight, and provide the whole proteins with the same negative ratio, which is 1.4 gram for SDS for 1 gram protein, and hence it provide the same charge to mass ratio for different proteins. Other point, as I said, it's stratify. It means like unfold the proteins. So those are two proteins. The first one doesn't contain any disulfide bonds, so it gets negatively charged and stratify. The other one have two disulfide bonds, and also it's very important to notice that SDS doesn't affect those disulfide bonds. So to deal with that, if it's needed, we might use some reducing agent like beta-murakabtoethanol. Beta-murakabtoethanol is a reducing agent like DTT and TCEP. It helps to reduce the disulfide bonds, and hence it provides the straight structure of the proteins and helps in unfolding. So to understand that more, let's assume that we have this protein with three disulfide bonds, and once beta-murakabtoethanol is added, those sulfide bonds are reduced. And this is also provide two types of SDS PAGE, one known as reducing, the other one is non-reducing. Basically, in reducing form, we use a reducing agent like DTT or beta مركب to ethanol. And in case of non-reducing SDS PAGE, we don't use. So let's assume that we have this protein with two polypeptide chains that were linked through two disulfide bonds. So by adding SDS alone, this will be get negative charge and stratify, but those two bonds will still exist, which means that when we do the electrophoresis in non-reducing form, only one band that will appear, and this band express the molecular weight of overall the two polypeptide chains. In case of reducing SDS PAGE, we have both SDS and also beta-murakabtoethanol as reducing agent, and hence the two strands is separated and also stratified and negatively charged. And during the electrophoresis, we will get two bands, each express the molecular weight of A strand and B strand respectively. So for this, reducing SDS PAGE help us to understand the polypeptide proteins more clearly. The last molecule is bromoethanol blue, which is a stain, blue stain, that is used to track the sample during the electrophoresis. So mainly we add SDS, which is surfactant, that to provide the same mass to charge ratio for all proteins, and hence it provide us the ability to separate the proteins based on one factor, which is molecular weight. So keep this in mind. The second step is gel preparation. Gel preparation is main step in any gel electrophoresis technique. So we use two molecules for that, which are acrylamide and bisacrylamide. Those are the base materials to form the sieving gel. And the polymerization depends on radical polymerization. And as we said in the very beginning in this video, SDS PAGE is discontinuous technique, which means that it has two phases of the gel. One is stacking and the other is resolving. Resolving is poured first and it is the down of the gel. So if we have this gel, the bottom is resolving. Resolving gel is higher in acrylamide and bisacrylamide concentration. It's also more alkaline and take the majority of the chamber. So it's about 75 to 80% of the total gel. Also, we have the stacking gel, which is less in concentration, lower in acrylamide concentration, and also it is more acidic and takes only 20% of the gel. So because of that, dissolving gel is more porous and which allow the band charming, means like a separation, the band is much better in the higher concentration of acrylamide. So how this gel is prepared? Pimid interact with ABS, and as a result, two free SO4 molecules are released. So those are represent free radicals. Those free radicals can interact with basic material molecules, mainly acrylamide and base acrylamide, and hence the process of radical polymerization is initiated. Once that acrylamide interacts with bisacrylamide, elongation is started randomly, which provide the cross-linking or the porous sieving gel. This is the same process for formation of stacking gel and also resolving gel. So the velocity during the electrophoresis depends on the strength of the electric field. So the strongest electric field provide more velocity of molecules. Proteins have the same mass to charge ratio because they are treated with SDS, and they will be separated only based on molecular weight because they have the same mass to charge ratio. They have subjected to the same electric field and they come across the stacking gel in the beginning and then through the resolving gel. Also, we have the running buffer. The running buffer is important because it provides the ions to conduct the electrophoresis through the gel. It mainly has two components, a trace, which is alkaline, 8.3. It is more acidic than the resolving gel, but it's still alkaline. And the most important thing is the glycine. Glycine is the simplest amino acid. This R is H, a hydrogen atom. So glycine is a Zwitterion amino acid, which means it has different charge in different pH environment. So mainly within more acidic environment, it becomes cationic. It takes positive charge. And when there is lacking in the concentration of protons, it takes negative charge in the high pH environment. And in between, it will be neutral. So as we know, each amino acid has pKa1 and pKa2. So the pKa1 value for glycine is 2.3 and pKa2 is 9.6. What does that mean? It means once the pH is 2.3 or lower, the glycine exists in the cationic form. And when it becomes more alkaline, more glycine molecules take the negative charge. Once it gets pH value of 9.6 or above, the whole molecules are negatively charged. So it's gradually charged according to the pH environment. So how does that affect the process of SDS PAGE? Mainly, the electrophoresis is performed by moving the molecules from negative pole to the positive pole. So first of all, we have the running buffer with pH of 8.3. The stacking gel is 6.8, which is a little bit acidic. And we have the alkaline environment 8.8 in the resolving gel. So once this glycine molecule reach the stacking gel, it becomes more acidic, means glycine molecules have positive charge, and which make its movement slower during the stacking gel. When it reach the resolving gel with pH of 8.8, it becomes more negatively charged. And hence, it's more likely to be attracted towards the positive pole because it exists in electric field during the electrophoresis. And hence, it's moving more faster in resolving gel. So mainly, we have three molecules to move from the negative pole to the positive pole of the gel. Chloride, which is provided by the trace in the sample preparation buffer, that was trace HCl, so HCl is chloride, and because of this negatively charged ion, it's the highest in speed, so it's represented in this colored blue point. The glycine molecule, which exists in slightly acidic environment, will be slower, and the protein SDS complex will be in between. So for this point, this gel is called stacking gel because the protein is stacked between glycine and chloride. But once those molecules come across the resolving gel, as you expect, chloride is the fastest one. The next one is glycine, which is become more faster, as we said, and the protein SDS complex is left behind. So this is a mechanism of separation in SDS PAGE. SDS PAGE has many applications. The main application is to detect or measure the molecular weights of different proteins. Also, we can use it to detect different polypeptides or different forms, like recognition between HIV type 1 and type 2. Also, to examine the purity of proteins. SDS PAGE also can be used for further molecular techniques like 2DE, which is two-dimension electrophoresis, and Western plot, and immunoplotting also. And by this, we can detect some post-translational modifications and epigenetic markers also. So thank you for watching. Please, if you have any question related to the topic, leave it in a comment and I will see it and try to provide the answer as soon as I can. Please hit the like button and subscribe the channel.